Hydra. Can you hear me properly, everyone? Can you hear me properly? Okay, good afternoon, everyone. Please let me know that can you hear me properly? Students, can you hear me properly? Students, can you hear me properly? Now can you hear me? Students, can you hear me properly right now? Now, can you hear me properly? Okay, so everyone open your copy and start writing the part that is up to the procedure we have completed in our previous class, right? So today we will start with the observation. So first heading is observation. And under the observation, subheading A, and write down binary fission in amoeba. Okay, now I will tell you the points under binary fission in amoeba. So under this, first point is under the heading, under first heading is observation and then binary fission and amoeba. First point is that okay, I am telling you what. Amoeba, first point, amoeba shows one nucleus. Amoeba shows one nucleus and irregular pseudopodia and irregular pseudopodia, comma, cytoplasm and cell membrane I am repeating the first point that amoeba shows one nucleus and irregular pseudopodia comma, cytoplasm and cell membrane. Cytoplasm and cell membrane. I am repeating the point number one. Amoeba shows one nucleus and irregular pseudopodia. Amoeba shows one nucleus and irregular pseudopodia, comma, cytoplasm and cell membrane. Next point number two. Next point number two. During the binary fission in amoeba, during the binary fission in amoeba, following steps can be followed. During the binary fission in amoeba, following steps can be followed. Then give a dash. Under this point, a subheading, not heading, a subpoint, that is A. Dash, after that a subpoint A. During the binary fission in amoeba, following steps are followed. Dash. Point number A. Parent cell elongates and constriction appears. Point number A. Parent cell elongates. Point number A. Parent cell elongates and a constriction appears. Parent cell elongates and a constriction appears. Point number B. Nucleus also elongates. Point number B. Nucleus also elongates. Point number B. Nucleus also elongates. Point number C. Nucleus divides into two nuclei. Point number C. Nucleus divides into two nuclei. 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 Nucleus divides into two nuclei. Stop. This is called nuclear division. This is called nuclear division. Next, point number D. Then cytoplasm also divides. Then cytoplasm also divides. Then cytoplasm also divides. Divide cell into two daughter cells. This divide cell into two daughter cells. Point number D. The cytoplasm also divides. This divide cell into two daughter cell. These divide cell into two daughter cells. Now make a para and write, the parent amoeba cell divides, the parent amoeba cell divides to form two new individuals. The parent amoeba cell divides to form two new individuals. And this amoeba is parent amoeba. From the parent amoeba we get that new elongation of nucleus is taking place. So this is the elongated nucleus, and after that the nucleus will divide into two and the constriction in the cytoplasm will take place, and then two new daughter amoeba will be formed, and these are the daughter nuclei in new amoeba. Now can you see the board? Okay. Here it is written as these two are under these two you have to write daughter amoeba and these two are daughter nuclei in new amoeba. And at the bottom of the diagram you have to write that binary fission in amoeba. Figure is that you have to write down the caption of the figure, that is binary fission in amoeba. Don't forget to write that part. Completed everyone? Okay. So let's move to the next. Next heading, that is budding in east. Next heading under B, write down that budding in east. Next heading is that budding in east. And under the budding in east, start writing that during the budding in east, following steps can be seen. During the budding in east, following steps can be seen. Then dash. Under this point number A, a small protuberance, spelling is protuberance, 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 a small protuberance or outgrowth arises from the parent plant. And this is called bud. A small protuberance or outgrowth arises from the parent plant. And this is called bud. BUD. And this is called bud. BUD. Okay, Sneha? Good. Next point. The nucleus divides into two daughter nuclei. The nucleus divides The nucleus divides into two daughter nuclei. NUCLEI. Nucleus divides into two daughter nuclei. Next, point number C. Point number C is one of the nucleus passes into the bud. One of the nucleus passes into the bud. Next point number D. This process is repeated to form many buds. This process is repeated to form many buds. Next, point number E. Now these buds develop into small individuals. Then para. When fully mature, comma, they detach from the parent cell. They detach from the parent cell and become new independent organism. Then draw the diagram. that this one is the parent, parentist nucleus. Then this one is the developing bud. Bud is developing now. This one is the new bud, and after that chain of buds has been formed. This one is the parentist cell, and this one is the detached bud. Okay, this bud will fall off on the ground, and from this a new yeast will form. Figure, budding in yeast. Completed, everyone? Okay, Somodip and Amit. Okay, so okay, Sneha. Okay, very good. Now next heading. Next heading is budding in Hydra. Next heading is budding in Hydra. Under that budding in Hydra, write down that in the point number one, in the process of budding in Hydra, in the process of budding in Hydra, a bud develops as an outgrowth. A bud develops as an outgrowth. In the process of budding in Hydra, a bud develops as an outgrowth. Due to repeated cell division at one specific site. Due to repeated cell division at one specific site, next point, these buds develop into tiny individuals. Next point, these buds develop into tiny individuals. Next point, these buds develop into tiny individuals. these buds develop into tiny individuals. In the budding in Hydra, a bud develops as an outgrowth due to repeated cell division at one specific site. This is the first point. In the budding in Hydra, a bud develops as an outgrowth due to repeated cell division at one specific site. Second point is that these buds develop into tiny individual. And the last point, after maturation, buds detach from the parent body. After maturation, buds detach from the parent body. After maturation, buds detach from the parent body and become new independent individuals. So, the observation part is completed. Now you have to draw the budding in Hydra. You can draw it from your theory book, okay, which is in page number 131. They draw the diagram from the theory book, okay. And those who are not having the practical copy, just send your parents to the school and buy the practical copy from the school. You have to buy it from the school, okay. So the office is open. You can send your parents any day within Monday to Friday and start writing in your main practical copy, okay. So only observation, conclusion, result and precaution part is left. So I will complete that part in my next class, and I am providing you a website. From there you will get the videos of that particular practicals which is in your syllabus, okay. Just follow the website. There you will get videos, animation and procedures and theories also there. But write this one what I have told you, but follow that. Some Viva questions are also over there, so check that website, okay. There you will get the practicals. www.olabs.edu.in, okay. Check it and let me know in my next class that whether you have got it or not, okay. Clear everyone? Okay, so thank you everyone and bye bye. Take care.